Hello students, welcome to the 7th session on applications of derivatives. So in this video, so we will study about tangents and normals. So in the last videos, already we studied rate measure and increasing and decreasing functions. So in this applications of derivatives, this is a third concept. So let us start with first. Meaning of derivative at a particular point. Meaning of derivative at a particular point. Now consider a curve y equal to f of x and here point A on this curve. Now suppose if you draw a tangent, that is slope of the tangent at A is the derivative. Slope of the tangent at A is the derivative. Now the definition is derivative of y equal to f of x at point A is nothing but slope of tangent at point A on the curve. So derivative of this function at this point A is nothing but slope of the tangent at point A. So this is an important point, students, you have to remember. Next. Now, if you draw a line which is perpendicular to this tangent, a line perpendicular to the tangent at the same point is called normal. So, this is the difference between slope of the tangent and normal. So, first tangent is, so you can draw a tangent to a given function at point A, so that is a, we call it the slope of the tangent. Next, one line if you draw which is perpendicular to this tangent, that one we call as a normal. Therefore, slope of the normal to the curve is equal to minus of 1 divided by slope of the tangent. So this line is perpendicular to the slope means, so already we know that the slope, the product of this slope, when two lines are perpendicular, then product of slope equal to minus 1. Okay. Now therefore by using that concept, the slope of the normal to the curve is minus 1 divided by slope of the tangent. The next, derivative of y equal to x square on graph paper. Derivative of y equal to x square. Now you consider this graph. So this is a point 1, 1. Next, draw this tangent at 1, 1. Now these are the points on this line, that is 2, 3, and this is 0, -1. Now here this slope formula is, when two points are given, y2 - y1 divided by x2 - x1. So what we get here, that is difference between, that is y2 - y1 and x2 - x1. So we get the first value is 4 and this denominator is 2. So the slope is 2. Now slope of the tangent at 1, 1 is 2. Also the derivative is 2. That is dy by dx at, here the given point is 1, 1. Dy by dx at 1, 1 is 2. So here the slope at 1, 1, or the slope of this line, the slope of the line is nothing but the derivative of this given curve at this point 1, 1. Next examples. First example, find the slope of the tangent to the curve y equal to 3 into x raised to 4 minus 4x at x equal to 4. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve. So slope of the tangent is nothing but the derivative. So here y equal to given. So in this example, you have to find out dy by dx and then dy by dx at x equal to 4. So first, slope of the tangent to the curve, that is y equal to f of x at x1, y1 is nothing but dy by dx at x1, y1. By using this formula, so first you have to differentiate this given function with respect to x. So therefore dy by dx equal to 3 into x raised to 4 is the given term. So derivative of this term is 12x cube. Derivative of minus 4x is minus of 4. Then slope of the tangent at x equal to 4 is given by dy by dx. Dy by dx here at x equal to 4. So put x equal to 4 in the right hand side, we get 12 into x raised to 4 is there. So 4 raised to 3 minus of 4. Or this implies 12 into, so 4 raised to 3 is 64 minus of 4. Now next you can simplify this term, we will get 768 minus 4, that is 764. So dy by dx at x equal to 4 is 764. Therefore, slope of the tangent to the curve at x equal to 4 is 764. So this is the final answer. Next, example number 2. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve y equal to x minus 1 divided by x minus 2, where x is not equal to 2 at x equal to 10. Slope of the tangent to the curve, so this is a given curve, you have to find out slope of the tangent at this curve at x equal to 10. Now first you can start with, again by using the same formula, the slope of the tangent to the curve, that is y equal to f of x at x1, y1 is given by dy by dx at x1, y1. So by using the same formula, so first you have to differentiate this given function with respect to x. So we get dy by dx equal to, students if you want you can start with y equal to, first if you want you can write down first y equal to given and then you can write dy by dx. So dy by dx equal to x minus 1 divided by, so here by using u by v rule, so by using u by v rule, second term as it is, derivative of first term, derivative of first term minus first term as it is, derivative of the second term or derivative of this denominator by using u by v rule. So denominator is x minus 2 whole square. Now I can simplify this one. Dy by dx equal to x minus 2 term as it is, then derivative of x minus 1 is, we'll get 1 minus sign, this x minus 1 term as it is, derivative of x minus 2, derivative of x is 1, derivative of minus 2 is 0. So whole divided by x minus 2 whole square. Now next, if we simplify this one, we will get x minus 2 minus of x minus 1 divided by x minus 2 whole square. Now x minus 2, if you multiply by minus sign, minus x minus of minus plus 1 divided by x minus 2 whole square. Now I can cancel plus x and minus x. So plus x minus x get cancelled. So we get minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1 by x minus 2 whole square. Now next, therefore dy by dx, that is slope of the tangent at x equal to 10, is given by dy by dx at x equal to 10 is equal to minus 1 by,
So put x equal to 10 here. So 10 minus 2 whole square, or this equal to minus 1 by 8 square is 64. So this is a answer. Minus 1 by 64. Next, example number 3. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve y equal to x cube minus x plus 1 at the point whose x coordinate is 2. At the point, see here, in this example also you have to find out, you have to calculate slope of the tangent. Okay, this is a curve at the point whose x coordinate is 2. So x coordinate is 2 means, so we can consider that term is, or first slope of the tangent to this y is nothing but f of x at x1 y1 is given by dy by dx at x1 y1. So first differentiate this given curve with respect to x. Differentiate this curve with respect to x. We get dy by dx equal to, so derivative of this x cube is 3x square, derivative of minus x is minus 1. Next, slope of the tangent at x equal to, so here x coordinate is 2 means the value of x is 2 is given. So therefore the slope of the tangent at x equal to 2 is given by dy by dx at x equal to 2 equal to 3x square minus 1. Next, you can substitute to x equal to 2 here, we get 3 into 4 minus 1, that is 11. 12 minus 1 is 11. So slope of the tangent to the curve at x equal to 2 is 11. So this is the answer. Next, example number 4. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve y equal to x cube minus 3x plus 2 at the point whose x coordinate is 3, means x equal to 3. Now first you can write down this given term x cube minus 3x plus 2, then differentiate with respect to x. Dy by dx equal to 3x square, derivative of x cube is 3x square, derivative of minus 3x is minus 3. Then by using this formula, dy by dx at x equal to 3 is given by 3 into 3 square minus 3. So 9 into 3 is, you can take 27 minus 3. 27 minus 3. Will get 24. So therefore the slope of the tangent to the curve is 24. So same method is there. First differentiate this function with respect to x, and then you have to substitute x equal to 3. Next, example number 5. Find the slope of the normal to the curve x equal to a cos cube theta, y equal to a sin cube theta at theta equal to pi by 4. So students, so the given function is a parametric function. Okay, so for this function you have to find out slope of the normal. So here the given point is theta is equal to pi by 4. So first, so we can start with, so here the parametric function is given. So parametric function, differentiation of this x equal to f of theta, y equal to f of theta. Then dy by dx, first you have to find out, dy by dx is nothing but dy by d theta divided by dx by d theta. So first here, write down this first equation, and first you find out what is dy by d theta. So before that one, dy by dx is nothing but dy by d theta divided by dx by d theta. Now this equal to, so first dy by d theta. So what is dy by d theta? Dy by d theta means differentiate this function with respect to theta. A is a constant term, derivative of sine cube is 3 into a constant term as it is 3 into sine square theta with respect to sine theta is cos theta divided by dx by d theta. Dx by d theta is a is a constant term as it is. Derivative of cos cube is 3 cos square theta with respect to cos is minus sine theta. Now you can cancel this a constant term as well as 3, and then so we get sine theta, that is sine square, you can consider as sine theta into cos. So this one also cos into minus sine, then you can cancel the terms. We get dy by dx equal to sine by, that is minus sine by cos theta. That term is nothing but minus of tan theta. So this is a dy by dx. Now next you have to calculate dy by dx at theta is equal to pi by 4. So we get minus tan pi by 4. So tan pi by 4 means tan 45. So tan 45 is 1. So answer is minus 1. So therefore slope of the tangent to the curve is minus 1. So student, this is a not answer. Now next you have to find out normal. So this is a slope of the tangent we got. Now next, slope of the normal to the curve is nothing but minus 1 divided by slope of tangent. By using that formula, so here 1 minus 1 by, this is a slope of the tangent, minus 1 by slope of the tangent, that is formula for normal, that is slope of the normal. This term equal to minus 1 divided by minus 1. So the answer is plus 1. So this is a required term. Slope of the normal to the curve is 1. Next, example number 6. Find the slope of the normal to the curve x equal to 1 minus a sine theta and y equal to b cos square theta. So this is also parametric function is there. At theta equal to pi by 2. Theta equal to pi by 2. So in this example also slope of the normal you have to find out. So by using plus we have to find out slope of the tangent, and then slope of the normal is minus 1 by slope of the tangent. So first you find out slope of the tangent by using this formula. First you have to calculate what is dy by d theta by using this parametric function. Dy by d theta means differentiate this function with respect to theta. B into 2 times cos theta with respect to cos is minus sine theta. Now dy by d theta is equal to minus 2 times b cos theta into sine theta. Next dx by d theta. So differentiate this function with respect to theta. So derivative of this 1 is 0. And then derivative of this minus a sine theta with respect to theta is minus a term as it is. Derivative of this sine is, you will get cos. This is dy by d theta and this is dx by d theta. Then you substitute in this formula. We get dy by dx equal to minus 2b cos theta into sin theta divided by minus a cos theta. Next you have to simplify this term. We will get minus 2b cos theta sin theta divided by, so this minus sign get cancelled, then cos get cancelled. We get 2b by a into sin theta. Next dy by dx we got 2b divided by a into sin theta. Next dy by dx at theta is equal to 90 degree. Dy by dx at theta is equal to 90 degree. So we get 2b by a, this constant term as it is, sine of here theta is pi by 2. So sine pi by 2 is, we get 1. So here 1 into this term is 2b by a. Next slope of the tangent to the curve is 2 times b by a. So this is a slope of the tangent. By using this one, next you have to find out what is slope of the normal. Therefore, slope of the normal is minus 1 divided by the slope of the tangent. Slope of tangent is nothing but dy by dx at x equal to 90. So substitute here, minus 1 divided by, so this term you substitute here, 2b by a, or this implies minus a by 2b. So this is the answer. Slope of the normal to the curve is minus a divided by 2b. Next, example number 7. Find points at which the tangent to the curve y equal to x cube minus 3x square minus 9x plus 7 is parallel to the x-axis. Find the points at which the tangent to the curve y equal to x cube minus 3x square minus 9x plus 7 is parallel to the x-axis. So here, first write down, let P of x, y be the required point. Find the points, you have to calculate the points here at which the tangent to the curve is parallel to x-axis. For this curve, okay, or at what point the tangent is parallel to x-axis. So that point you have to calculate here. So let P of x, y be the required point. Then if any line parallel to the x-axis, then its slope is 0. So slope of the tangent will get 0, and slope of x-axis also will get 0 here. Okay, by using this one we will get curve in this form here. The tangent is parallel to x-axis, and slope of this x-axis or parallel to this x-axis, those slope values are always 0. Therefore, given term is dy by dx at x, y is 0. Therefore, dy by dx equal to 3x square, differentiate this function with respect to x, 3x square minus 6x minus 9. Now, dy by dx equal to 0 here, because the slope of this tangent is parallel to x-axis is there. Means in this equation, put dy by dx equal to 0. So 3x square minus 6x minus 9 equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation. Then next, find out the root values here. Or before that, we can take 3 common here. We'll get quadratic equation is x square minus 2x minus of 3 equal to 0. Then by using this quadratic equation, x square minus 2x minus 3 equal to 0. Because it is constant term, you can take on the right hand side, that term becomes 0. Now you can calculate the factors. So factors for this x square minus 2x minus 3 is x minus 3 into x plus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, x equal to, or you can take first x minus 3 equal to 0 or x plus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, x equal to plus 3 or x equal to minus 1. Now, this is the value of x. Now, put this value in the given equation, you get the corresponding value of y. When x equal to 3, then when x equal to 3, what is the value of y? That one you can calculate by using this given equation. So, when x equal to 3, so y equal to 3 raised to 3 minus 3 into 3 square minus of 9 into 3 plus 7. Once if we simplify this one, we get, now just to simplify this one, minus 27 plus 7, that is minus of 20. When x equal to 3, y equal to minus 20. Now similarly, when x equal to minus 1, you have to calculate corresponding what is the value of y. Now next, you substitute x equal to minus 1 in this equation. When x equal to minus 1, so we get y equal to minus minus 1 raised to 3 minus 3 into minus 1 square minus 9 into minus 1 plus 7. Therefore, y equal to minus 1 raised to 3 is minus 1 minus 1 square is plus 1 into minus 3 minus 3 minus into minus plus 9 plus 7. Now this implies we get minus 4 plus 16 equal to plus 12. So when x equal to minus 1, y equal to 12. So this is the second point. The point is 3 comma minus 20, and the second one is the point is minus 1 comma 12. Therefore, two points are, or the required these two points are 3 comma minus 20 and minus 1 comma 12. So this is the required points at which the slope of the tangent is parallel to x-axis. Next, example number 8. Find a point on the curve y equal to x minus 2 whole square at which the tangent is parallel to the chord joining the points 2, 0 and 4, 4. Find a point on the curve. So this is the equation of this curve at which the tangent is parallel to the chord joining these two points. Okay, so slope of this tangent parallel to the chord, the chord is joining of these two points. So those points you have to find out, or that point you have to calculate. Let P of x comma y be the required point. Then that the given that chord is parallel to the tangent. This chord is parallel to this tangent. Means slope of the chord and slope of the tangent, these two lines are parallel. Okay, these two lines are parallel. So here, if two lines are parallel, then their slopes are equal. Now by using this term, slope of the chord is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So by using these given terms, put y2, this is x1 y1 and this is x2 y2. So we get 4 minus 0 divided by 4 minus 2. So this implies 4 by 2. So that is slope of the chord is 2. Now slope of the chord and this slope both are parallel. So slope of the chord is nothing but slope of the tangent. And slope of the tangent is nothing but dy by dx value. Okay, for this curve. Now by using this term, slope of the tangent equal to 2 here. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to 2. Now, call this equation number 1. Then slope of the tangent is dy by dx at x1, y1. That is, equation of the given curve is y equal to x minus 2 whole square. Therefore, dy by dx equal to, so derivative of this x minus 2 whole square is 2 into x minus 2. With respect to x minus 2 is 1. So your answer is 2 into x minus 2. Or this implies 2 into x minus 2 equal to, from equation number 1. What is the dy by dx value here? 2. Now you can equate this 2 into 2x minus 2 with this value here. So therefore 2 into x minus 2 equal to, we get 2. Then you can simplify this 2 to get cancelled. X minus 2 equal to 1. So x equal to 1 plus 2. So here x equal to, will get 3. And when x equal to 3, then what is the value of y? That one you can calculate by using the given function. Substitute x equal to 3 in the given term. So we get y equal to 3 minus 2 whole square. That is, 1 square is 1. Now here, when x equal to 3, y equal to 1. So this is a required point. Therefore, the point x comma y equal to 3 comma 1. So this is a required point. I hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you very much for watching this video, students. Thank you, students.